Good morning, students. Welcome to the 14th part of this chapter, Coordinate Geometry. In the previous lessons, we have discussed the formula for area of a triangle when the three vertices are given, and we have applied this formula to calculate the area of a triangle and the area of a quadrilateral. Now, in this class, we will interrelate the area of a triangle with the concept of collinear points. I'll show you some images. You try to understand the geometrical concept that is present in all these pictures. You observe this picture 1, and then this is 2. Here we have a third picture, and this is the last one. So you tell me, what is the geometrical concept that I am discussing here? Very good. It's actually a straight line. In all these cases, the common geometrical concept is a straight line. Here the ducklings are following their parents in a straight line, and these bicycles are arranged in a straight line, and these beads are present in a straight line, and the kids are doing their physical activity by standing in a straight line. So the concept here is a straight line. Now let us bring this concept of straight line to a plane. On a plane, as we know, we can plot infinite number of points. Of course, these are not actually the points, but for the understanding of concept only, I am taking the points as a circles here. Now, I have drawn here a straight line, and the name of the straight line is M. If you observe, there are few points on the straight line M. What are the names of the points? They are A, B, and C. I have drawn one more straight line. The straight line is P. And what are the points that are present on this straight line? They are actually E, F, G, and H. Now, these points are actually lying on the same straight line. A, B, C are on the straight line M, and E, F, G, H are on the straight line P. These points lying on the same straight line are called collinear points. So, the concept of collinear points is the points lying on the same line, same straight line, are called collinear points. Now the concept of collinear points is very, very important when we have the case of a triangle. Now we try to, you think, how can we draw a triangle passing through E, F, G, or making these three points as the vertices of a triangle? It's not possible. Can you draw a triangle using these points F, G, H as the vertices? It's not possible. So let us take this example. Here I have taken another plane, and I have taken three non-collinear points here. I have taken A, B, and C, and these are not on a straight line. So these are called non-collinear points. Now by joining these points, we can actually form a triangle. Now I have taken another case where you have the points P, Q, R, and by joining these, we can actually have a triangle. Now this is a triangle we have by joining the points P, Q, and R. Here also, the points P, Q, and R are also non-collinear points. Now I have taken another case where we have the three points X, Y, and Z. Now by joining these points also, I can have a triangle X, Y, and Z. So the concept here is, whenever you want to draw a triangle on a plane, the three points which you are taking cannot be on the same straight line. That is, they have to be non-collinear points. So the concept of triangle and the concept of collinear points are actually interrelated. You cannot have a triangle by joining collinear points. Now, whenever you have a triangle, it actually has some area surrounded by this boundary. This pink colored area and this white one and this yellow one are the areas of the triangles formed by these vertices. So whenever you have a closed figure, it definitely encloses some area in it. Now you observe this. Which letter is different from all the remaining? Yes, letter E is different here because it is not on the straight line joining all the remaining alphabets. E is actually out of the line. That is, I can say that E is not on the line. That is, E is non-collinear with the straight line joining A, B, C, D, F, G, and H. So here, by joining A, B, C, D, F, G, H, you cannot have a triangle, but you can have a triangle by joining AB with E or BD with E, because E is out of the line. So you can have a triangle by joining those kind of points. So let us have the case here. Now, as we know, we actually can calculate the area of the triangle formed by different vertices. Now, here I have three vertices. Now, I have to find the area of the triangle formed by three. This is A, 3, 3, B is 4, 2, and C is 5, 1. As we have already practiced so many problems involving this concept, x1, y1 is 3, 3, 4, 2 is x2, y2, and 5, 1 is x3 and y3. This is our very known formula, 1 by 2 modulus x1 of y2 minus y3 plus x2 of y3 minus y1 plus x3 of y1 minus y2. Now, by substituting the values here, what we have, 1 by 3 of x1 is 3 of y2 minus y3. So, this is 2 minus 1 plus x2 of y3 minus y1, which is 1 minus 3, plus x3 of y1 minus y2, which is 3 minus 2. As you know, 2 minus 1 is 1. So, here it will be 3 of 1. And 1 minus 3 is minus 2. So, here you will have 4 into minus 2. And here this is 3 minus 2 is 1. So, you have 5 of 1. Now you have, this is 3 ones are 3, 4 into minus 2 is minus 8, and 5 ones are 5. So this is what we have. And here 3 plus 5 will give you 8, and plus of minus 8 is minus 8. So here we have 8 minus 8, which is 1 by 2 modulus of 0. What is the absolute value of 0? 0 only. So this is 1 by 2 into 0. So the area of the triangle here is 0 square units. Now this is the important thing here. We have got area of the triangle as 0. Just as we discussed, whenever you have a closed figure, it definitely has some area. But here we have got the area as 0. Now let us try to understand why we got this case. Now here, I have plotted the three points that I have considered when we solve this problem. A is 3, 3, B is 4, 2, and C is 5, 1. Now, by joining these three points A, B and C, did we get a triangle? No, actually they are on a same straight line. Here these points A, B and C are actually collinear points. So that is the concept here you have to understand. So when you got area of a triangle as 0, in such cases actually the points will be collinear. If the area of the triangle formed by three points is 0, then the three points are collinear. That is a concept that you have to understand here. When you calculate the area of a triangle, if you get the area as 0, which means the three points are collinear. Let us take the converse of this. Here I have taken collinear points only. Now, after taking these collinear points, now as we know, can you form a triangle by joining PQR? It's not possible, because these three are on a straight line. So when you calculate, when there is no triangle here, you cannot have the area. So the area of the triangle will be 0, because P, Q and R are collinear points. Now, so the three, there is no triangle formed here, because the points P, Q and R are collinear. So that is area of the triangle PQR is 0. Here we have discussed two things. In the previous case, we have calculated the area of the triangle, and we got area of the triangle as 0, which implies that the points are collinear. Now we have taken here PQR as collinear points. So whenever you take the collinear points, you will have the area of the triangle formed by them is 0. We have to discuss these two concepts, because using this formula and connecting that with the concept of collinear points, you will be asked two different types of problems. One is to check if the given points are collinear. So whenever you want to check if the points are collinear, we have to calculate the area of the triangle by using the three points. In this case, you will have two different cases. One is, you will get the area 0, which means the points are collinear. But when you have area as non-zero, for example, you get area as 15 or 14, 6.5 and so on, that is, which is not 0, then the points are not collinear. If the points are not collinear, then you will have some area. But when you have the points are collinear, the area will be 0. So after calculating the area, if you get the area as 0, you have to write the points are collinear. If you get area some positive value, you have to write the points are not collinear. And the second concept here will be, given 3 points are collinear, then find the value of the missing coordinate. And in the second case, you actually will be given that the points are collinear, but in the 3 points, some of the coordinates will be missing. That is, x and y from any one of the points will be missing. In that case, what you have to do is, you have to take the area and you have to calculate the area using the formula. And you have to make this area equal to 0. Then you have to solve that linear equation which you get. Sometimes you may get a quadratic equation also. So this is how you have to solve problems involving collinear points by connecting that with the concept of area of a triangle. Let us solve problems for each of these cases. Now this is example 1. Check if the points are collinear. As I told you, whenever you want to check if the points are collinear, you have to find the area of the triangle formed by them. As you know, you have to calculate the area by using this formula. Here, this is what I have substituted the values. I am not going to the explanation because we have solved so many problems involved in this. Here I got the area as 1 by 2 modulus of negative 15. What is the absolute value of minus 15? It's actually 15. So 1 by 2 into 15. Half of 15 is 7.5 square units. Is the value 0? No, the value as is not 0. It's actually 7.5 square units. So which means the given points are not collinear. This is what you have to write. But when you calculate the area, if you get the area as 0, just we got in the first problem, you have to write the points are collinear. So whenever you are given a problem to check if the given points are collinear, you have to find the area of the triangle by using those 3 points. If you get the area 0, you have to write the points are collinear. But if you get the area as non-zero, you have to write the points are not collinear. Let us consider another model here. Find the value of P if the points 2, 3, minus 1, P and 4, 1 are collinear points. Here if you look at this, one coordinate is missing. But what is the condition we are given here? We are given that the points are collinear. This is the second concept. This is the second model. As the points are collinear, you have to calculate once again the area of the triangle formed by using these vertices. But in case of one number, you will have a variable here. So wherever you have y2, you have to write p. Take this actually x1 of y2 minus y3. So this is 2 of p minus 1. So in place of y2, you have to write p. Plus x2 of y3 minus y1, this will be 1 minus 3, plus x3 of y1 minus y2, which is 3 minus p. Let us multiply these two. 2 into p is 2p, 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. And here minus 1 of 1 is 1, minus 1, and minus 1 into minus 1 is plus 3. 4 3s are 12, 4 into minus p is minus 4p. So here we have some variable terms and we have some constants. So here by simplifying the constants, actually this is minus 2 and minus 1 of minus 2 is plus 2 and plus 12. This is 2p and minus. So when you have these terms, this is what we have. So here you have 2p minus 2 plus 2 plus 12 and minus 4p. Actually these two are like terms. 2p minus 4p will give you minus 2p, and minus 2 plus 2 will be 0 and this will be plus 12. That is what here we have. So here we have 1 by 2 modulus of minus 2p plus 12. This is the area we have. But since the given points are collinear, we have to equate this value with 0. That means 1 by 2 modulus of minus 2p plus 12 is 0 here. You observe this value. This is 1 by 2 into a particular value is giving you 0. When the product of two values is 0, one of them should be 0. Here half cannot be 0. So the value in this modulus, absolute values taken, should be 0. That means minus 2p plus 12 is actually 0. It's a simple linear equation. You have to transpose this plus 12 to the other side. Then you will have minus 12, which is minus 2p is equal to minus 12. And minus 2 is multiplying p here. When you take it to the other side, when you transpose it to the other side, it will actually divide. So you have p is equal to minus 12 by minus 2, which will give you 6. So the value of P here is 6. So whenever you are given 3 points are collinear, you will be having 1 or 2 coordinates missing in the points that we have to take. So you have to calculate the area using the 3 coordinate, 3 points, and you, after calculating the area, you have to equate that area with 0. Then you will have the missing variable here. So these are the two types of problems you will be having when you link the area of a triangle with the collinear point. So as usual, I am giving you here an assignment. Here you have to check if these two points are collinear or not, these three points. And then you have to calculate the missing value of k here when these three points are collinear. This is model 1 and this is model 2. Here you have to calculate the area. If you get the area as 0, you have to write the three points are collinear. But if you get a value, a positive value other than 0, you have to write the given points are non-collinear. Here you have to calculate the area and you have to equate that area with 0 to find the value of k. So these are the two models you will be having with the concept of collinear points. So solve these problems and post the solutions to me. Thank you.